been no harvest of victories for either the Chiefs or the Lions during this 1987 season. We go out to the Silver Dome, Dick Enberg and Merlin Olsen. Dick, a Thanksgiving test for you guys. Make this one interesting.
Thanks a lot, Robert. As one of the writers here in Detroit said, this is not a game that's a turkey. It's the leftovers. But nevertheless, we go on, and it's a test of emotions, Merlin Olsen, and we're going to focus upon that today. You were with teams that almost won a Super Bowl or got there, and then you were with a team that won only one game. You can relate to these fellas.
I can relate to the losing side of it, and people are saying around the country, there's not much at stake here. There's no championship at stake here, no trip to the playoffs. But I got to tell you that there is a lot at stake on the field today. These teams are playing for pride, for the ability during this next week, if they win, to go to the supermarket without having to be hassled. What's wrong with your team? Why can't you win the game? Everybody's got the answers. They'd like to have their kids coming home from school without saying, boy, they're talking about your team, Dad, and the wives are in on it, too. And I'll tell you, there is an awful lot at stake in this game today.
That's an interesting line. Some teams are playing to go to the Super Bowl. These teams are playing just to be able to go to the supermarket.
Absolutely. Well, and there's something else, too, Dick, that has to be interesting. These teams are excited about having a couple of extra days off after this Thanksgiving Day game. And if they win, they can really enjoy that little break from the season. If they lose, however, they've got to carry that pain on through that, and it will kind of destroy that little holiday vacation they had in mind.
Take us back to that Rams year when you won only one game.
It's still a game we won against the 49ers, the only game we won in my rookie year, and I remember vividly players crying in the locker room, tears of joy, and the rest of it, and I'm saying to myself, why was it that in the games where everything was going well for us, we won 11 in a row one year, those games kind of melded together. I do remember that one game that we won back in 1962 very vividly.
So the emotions, the psychology of professional football, we're going to get some added help. We're going to call upon a doctor to analyze what we're about to see. Welcome back to the Silver Dome on this Thanksgiving Day, and for the two teams, the Chiefs and the Lions, two of the worst records in all of the NFL. So how do you get up emotionally, mentally for this game? We asked both coaches yesterday. They gave us the same answer, and that is national television. That's the reason why my players want to play well today. We have with us today Dr. Eric Marginau from New York, a sports psychologist. He has written some columns for the New York Daily News, and by the way, is 5-0 in his picks as we analyze the mental emotional state of these teams in this game. You've picked out three of your 10 factors you feel that are most important.
Well, state of mind first comes to mind, Dick. With the Lions, you have a team that's had to get up for three games in a row. They beat Dallas, they played Washington real tough in RFK, and then got blown out by Chicago. They have to get up for a fourth game in a row. The Chiefs, on the other hand, are a team that went to the playoffs last year. They were 10-6. They know how to win. This is a big game for them. Their image is at stake. I give the nod to the Chiefs in this area.
So even though the Chiefs are 1-9 this year, the fact that they've had a more recent successful experience last year's playoff team, you give them the state of mind plus the Lions having four tough games. Now, team chemistry.
When I look at the team's chemistry, Kansas City is in the midst of a quarterback controversy. They've started with Kenny. They came to Sire, now they're back to Kenny again. Blackledge has been put on the shelf completely. Unconsciously, this has to affect that team. And so in this area, I give the edge to the Lions.
All right, the Lions and Chiefs, so thus far at least, we're assuming this is an even game. I hope it's not scoreless. Let's go to leadership.
Well, here will be the deciding factor. When we break down leadership, we got coaching leadership and we got on-field leadership. Rodgers, and talking to him, you get the feeling that this is a really nice man, but you don't get his intensity. That's the kind of thing that I look for in an NFL head coach. Frank Gans, on the other hand, is a coach that the players have asked for themselves. Comes out of a military background. He knows how to lead men. When you look at the on-field leadership, you're basically looking at the quarterbacks here. Chuck Long is a young kid. When you talk with him, you feel this kid is a natural leader. But he's young, and it's really only his first year, even though he played two games last year. He doesn't audible. By his own admission in talking to me yesterday, he almost never does that. Kenny, on the other hand, has the experience, and Kenny, in the midst of this quarterback controversy, has to come up real big. I think he has extra incentive, and that gives the Chiefs, once again, the edge in this all-important category.
So even though the Kansas City Chiefs are less than an under touchdown underdog, you're picking them today.
I think they're going to come up real big today, Dick. I think they're going to blow the Lions out.
Well, that'll come as good news to one man back in New York, and he's with Bob Costas.
Well, Dick, that's right. Not to be outdone, you have Dr. Marginal, but of course, Paul McGuire is a longtime consultant to Dr. Irwin Corey. Now, this guy, the guy with the beard, is 5-0, pal. He says the Chiefs.
Yeah, I say the Chiefs, too, but not for those reasons. The reason I'm taking the Chiefs, they're mad. See, they're not having Thanksgiving at home. Detroit is. They can leave the game and go eat that big old turkey. Kansas City's got to get on a plane and eat those turkey sandwiches, cold ones. And that makes them mad. So they want to get this thing over with in a hurry, and Kansas City will win this ballgame. I can't see any of these teams giving the other one 5 points or 5.5 points. Some people say it may go to 6 or 6.5. You got to take Kansas City. I think they're the better team on defense, even though they haven't shown it all year.
So take Kansas City and the points.
Yeah, and take the good doctor.
Go ahead. All right, Dallas and the Vikings. And the Vikings, although they are the visitors, yeah, are favored by one.
Well, I like this where the home team gets points. And, you know, even though they played last week, we're talking about two games that most people really don't care too much about, except Minnesota does. But I'm taking Dallas. I think that Danny White's going to start at quarterback. And if you looked at Pollard last week playing, the only guy he threw to was Herschel Walker.
Yeah.
And Danny White knows that there are other receivers on the team. He's going to throw it to him, and I think the defense will respond. It's going to be a good football game. I think the Kansas City-Detroit will be a good football game. They may not score it, but it'll be a good game.
Dallas still has a wild card shot.
Oh, I understand. I'm just saying it's going to be a good football game, but I like Dallas because they are getting points at home. And that's one of the main reasons. And Danny White starting at quarterback.
Speaking of good